Beauty and the Beast, right?
The home show.
The home show.
That weren't drinking last night.
Yeah. There's LG if you know how to handle it.
Okay. Either that or you're the professional.
Or they're still drunk.
You're like three Advil and some water.
Thank you.
Oh, we don't have a moderator. I was expecting somebody to be here.
Do
you
need a moderator?
Now that's what I'm talking about. So, welcome to the Power Rangers panel. We have Mr. Walter Jones, Miss Karen Ashley Aisha, the yellow one, also the only other yellow to wear the original Mighty Morphin yellow suit, and Mr. David Yost, Billy, the Blue Ranger.
And of course, we have the wonderful
and
talented Mr. Austin St. John.
So you guys, what do you guys want to do? You want to do like Q&A, just let them fire away?
Yeah.
All right, well, since it's not so big a crowd, why don't you guys just line up right here? Whoever wants to ask a question, don't kill each other, no knives or guns, please. We'll try and keep it quick. Don't be one of these guys that's like, I have a three-part question. Just hit us with one question, line it up, and go from there.
He's our mic guy.
Okay, so he's got the mic for questions for you guys. And fire away. We'll just go that route.
Can we, so people's views don't get blocked, can we line up like this way?
Yeah, let's line up over here on the side, going towards the door. And when you're ready to ask the question, first person in line comes up to me, and I'll hand them the mic. That way you're not asking from the corner of the room.
I'm going to keep standing here just because I like
it.
Also, this one's not the best mic, so don't, like, kiss it, lick it to get closer. Please be clean.
Hello, thanks again for coming.
Thank you.
Oh, you're welcome. I guess my question is, what made each of you want to get into martial arts and or show business? That's all I got.
Good question.
That's a good question.
That's a good question.
Say what to? Well, actually, I got into martial arts as a child because I grew up in Detroit. It's kind of a dangerous city. My mom didn't want me to be bullied, so she was like, all right, let's put him in martial arts. So I started studying when I was a kid. I was Michigan Pee-wee State champion. And,
nice.
And I don't know, I think my friends kind of motivated me to get into show business because they were always like, you're so funny. You're like, you should be on TV. I was like, I should. Okay. And so I'd always been doing drama and supporting. I got a scholarship to go to a school of performing arts. So I went to California to study. And from that point, it was like after spending all that money on college, it was like, I better make a career out of this. I got an agent, started going on auditions. And Power Rangers just happened to be one that I auditioned for. And they were looking for somebody that could do martial arts, dance, do gymnastics, and was a good actor, so
ta-da. Thank you very much.
We're going to try and keep it.
No.
If we all answer, we'll be here all day, so we're kind of spread it around.
Sorry.
No worries. We just want to make sure we get as many questions as possible.
Hi.
Hi.
This is my first time seeing you all after watching Power Rangers for many years. Yeah, I'm now stuck with Super Sentai and some other stuff, and I have another superhero movie that I have planned or cartoons. Wow. So, have you guys seen the 199 Super Sentai movie? It came out in 2012, and it has your characters in it.
What'd you just say?
Have you ever seen the Super Sentai 199 movie?
It has Super Sentai.
Yeah, it came before your Power Rangers, because it was the Power Rangers before yours.
Oh.
And all your characters are in it, fighting a huge army in the beginning.
I can tell you, I think we've all had pretty much about the same exposure to the original series, at least in the very beginning.
Oh.
I think we got to see maybe a 30-second clip. They were like, well, this is where your show came from.
Mm-hmm.
It's probably good they didn't show us more, because as it was, we were reading the script going, but I remember seeing, you know, the petite of stature Asian individuals in Power Ranger suits jumping around like crazy people. And so it was kind of cool, but I think I've seen bits and pieces. I know that we've met our original counterparts.
Oh, cool.
At Power Morphic kind of stuff.
Yeah, we have much respect for them as well.
Yeah, we really do.
Crazy work.
Yeah.
It was funny, their experience was similar to ours. Yeah, their experience was similar to ours. They were young, they were starting out the business, they worked crazy hours, and the show was a huge hit, but it was completely different. So, yeah, we didn't really get an opportunity to see any of the Sentai stuff until you guys started telling us about it, and we got curious, but they didn't show it to us.
When you refer to people as petite in stature, does that mean you're calling them short?
Oh,
yeah.
No.
Oh. Really short.
I think you use the word short.
Oh,
well,
no.
I was only going to say because none of us are tall.
No.
I mean, I didn't know if you had some illusion that we were like 6'2 or something like that. Just wanted
when
to make sure.
When I think of, okay, ladies, if you're petite, stand up.
Yeah.
Okay, that's what I'm talking about when I think petite. You could have been a great stunt double for the Japanese show. Whereas I have broad shoulders. I am not petite. Sir.
Okay.
Now, gentlemen.
Okay. I know where to find you later, man.
Thank you. And check out the movie. It's very good. It's also on YouTube.
Is it?
Yeah, it has a whole army of 199 Rangers.
I think that's why when they did the Mega War, they thought we were our Mega Super Mega.
Super Mega Smackdown.
Yeah.
It has the originals from the 50s and 60s, too.
Oh, very cool.
Wow.
Very cool. I'll have to check it out.
From the 50s and 60s? Did he just say that?
Yeah. Like, this did not start. Yeah, it was like a long time ago.
Hello, this is my brother Matthew.
Hi.
And he wants to ask you, if you change your color suit, which means you're like, if you were changing a suit, what would it be and why?
Like change, like, you know,
yeah, it could be a different color.
Yeah.
I mean, for me, I don't want to be a different color. I'm very happy being blue. So the way that it ended up is the way it's meant to be. But it's a good question.
Same here. I like yellow, but if I had to, I probably would want to be a Red Ranger because it seems like they're the leaders. So I'd want a girl to be the girl to rule the world.
I knew she was watching me like that. I knew it. She's hunting my spot, man.
I'm gonna steal your helmet off your.
I'm sticking with the black. Gotta go with the Black Ranger.
Yeah.
I'm one of the guys I got to change, so I had red, which is kind of where my heart lies, but I love being black and gold, too, so the Golden Ranger was, for 17 episodes, he still had a global impact, so you can't find hardly any of his stuff out there, so I got to be a playboy, and then I got to be the rock solid leader, so I'm happy.
We dress alike.
Facebook, so this would be for your three. Did you guys ever realize that Power Rangers still to this day in 2017 would be this popular?
So for those of you that can't hear in the audience, he just asked us if we realized that Power Rangers was still going to be this popular in 2017.
Anyone?
No. He asked this on my Facebook the other day, yeah, so I'll stay out.
I think for all of us, if you would have told us 20 plus years ago that we'd be here in Sacramento talking about Power Rangers as if it were, you know, you guys, it's like brand new with you guys, and you guys still love it, you still watch it, it's just everything. I mean, I don't think we would have thought that. I mean, I knew going in that it was a hit show, and I knew these guys had broken barriers with this show, but you just think, oh, you know, because there are a lot of hit shows that come out, and you just think 20 years from now, you know, it's something you may or may not mention, you know, it'd be a line on your resume. So absolutely not. I wouldn't have thought we'd travel the world talking about Power Rangers.
No, I mean, if you guys look at yourselves or you guys as an audience, there's like three generations, you know, it's like there's the parents of the kids that used to be you, and there's you guys with your own kids now, so it's kind of weird. It's like, I never thought that it would go beyond that one generation, but it's progressing. I mean, we've done, like, there was a Samsung commercial that came out a couple of years ago, and it was like for a wristwatch, right? And we were with, like, Captain, they showed us, the Rangers, with Captain Kirk and Astro from the Jetsons, and I was like, wow, it's like with all these iconic people that I grew up with, and I was like, we're part of that. And now, for me, it's amazing. I'm like, wow, that's really kind of cool.
Yeah.
Thank you.
Good question.
My question is, out of all the villains you guys had to face on Power Rangers, which was your most hardest challenge, I guess?
Goldar. Breakfast, lunch, and dinner every day. Goldar.
You said a good one.
I liked giving Rita a headache, but that wasn't hard. take a 5-minute break. We'll be back with an answer. In the meantime. Oh, okay. There they are. They're right there.
Hi. I think it was a slightly different question. Yeah, but I think the hardest challenge I think that Zach faced, one of the challenges was getting beyond his fears. So he had Island of Illusions where he was scared of snakes and so forth and so on. And then the spiders, he was always afraid of something, but he's afraid of Angela, but he kept going for her. So I think just getting beyond his fears, Zach's problem.
Yeah, I mean, we fought over 200 monsters, so it's really hard to choose, you know? But downstairs, there's the armadillo monster from the actual TV show, if you haven't seen it. It's next to Austin's booth, so go check it out. And I just remember that one because we had to film in a park, and the armadillo turns into, like, a ball.
I never saw that thing when it wasn't a ball.
Yeah, I know.
I was wondering what that damn thing was. I was like, what is that?
So, and we had to jump over the ball and all that kind of stuff. So that's what's sitting next to you. Is that,
I remember
that
the
armadillo
ball.
Monster. Great question.
It's really hard to keep track, you know, when you're just fighting all of them so much.
Yeah. There's a lot of different monsters.
But Lord Zed, you know, he was awesome too, just like Goldar. But,
thank you.
Hey guys, thanks for coming out. Also, happy belated, David.
Thank you.
Yeah.
Okay.
So, I'm 62 years old.
Oh, wow.
You don't look a day over 30.
No.
68.
So, one of the craziest things I've heard on a Power Ranger set is a production assistant took a motorcycle and went joyriding and then got fired for doing that. And I only know that story because that production assistant was my friend who did that. That's what I heard. So my question is, what's the craziest thing that you guys seen, heard, or done on a set on the Power Rangers?
Seen, heard, or done?
Wow. Not to incriminate you. That's all.
I mean, I know when you're talking about people being fired, I mean, I do know there was what we call grips that kind of help with the lighting. And all the electrical stuff, one of them did steal a Blue Ranger outfit and was fired.
Oh, wow.
So I remember that day, because they were like trying to find my outfit.
Oh, wow.
That, I think? Yeah, I remember they did steal.
And they questioned me at first, and I was like, what are you talking about? I don't even know where to find that.
I wear this thing every day. I know what it smells like. Why would I steal it?
There was one episode where we had the shoot done in Venice Beach, and this was just crazy that it happened because it's a professional show, but we didn't have a permit, so we had to jump in the van and film it and then jump back in the van and like run away. So all people coming, they're like, all right, jump out of the van, here we go, ready, shoot, and we're shooting, like, get back in the van, get back in the van. Like, aren't we a professional show? Is this... All right, I just remember that happened, it was weird.
Power Rangers always followed the rules except when we filmed the show.
Low budget blues, baby.
Yeah, we talk about swimming in a lake. You guys had to swim in the lake.
Yeah, they would come out and this lake, no swimming was allowed. We all knew it. They would go out, remove the no swimming signs, and be like, "Okay, get in the lake."
And then throw us.
It's like, I feel like you're setting me up here. TMZ is gonna get this any minute.
All right, thanks a lot, guys.
Thank you.
James, nice to meet you, man.
Do you have to train to be a Power Ranger?
You have to train?
Yeah, well, because he did a little bit of Taekwondo. He wants to know if maybe, because I know you said that you did some kind of martial arts prior to, but he wanted to know if everybody else had to train for the role.
Yeah,
absolutely. We have to train. I trained as a kid to get more skills. The more skills you have, the more things you can develop, your brain or your body or whatever, all those things apply to being able to become a Power Ranger. Like, what did you have to do last year?
How old are you, buddy?
Six.
I started in the martial arts when I was about five, the morning of my fifth birthday. And I've been training off and on ever since. So I can remember from my role, before they even had me read a line, they were like, show us your martial arts. So I had to know martial arts. But the training never stops. Once you get the job, buddy, that's when you got to train even harder because you got to continue to get better at it, right? So as long as you keep training and listening to your mom and dad and getting good grades, you'll be
that's
all right.
Right. Yeah.
That's right.
Good job, James. Thank you.
Hey, James, I have three kids. You listen to mom and dad the first time, right? Not the 15th time with your screen.
Hi there, how's it going?
Good.
I just wanted to make a comment, or I don't really have a question, but I just want to say thank you because you guys basically, how do I say this? I had a rough childhood. My mom had breast cancer at a young age. I mean, when I was young. So I had to help raise two younger sisters. One was six and one was a four-month-old. And you guys were the closest for a childhood for me. I would watch TV, you guys, every afternoon after school, the movie. Yeah. Thank you.
You're the real hero.
Yeah. Yeah.
I like law.
Well, yeah. We don't discriminate.
As long as you're representing, it doesn't matter what color.
Hey, how's it going, guys?
So
I had a question for Walter and Austin. Just curious, weren't you guys able to make the cut for the original Power Ranger movie?
Actually, we were both contracted for the original Power Ranger movie. The show wasn't union. We weren't treated the way we thought we should be treated. And we told them if they didn't change that, we were going to leave. Well, they didn't believe us. So myself, Walter, and Twee, we chose to stand up for what we believed was right, and we walked off the show.
It continues to be a non-union show.
I will say that Haim learned something because a lot of people got paid better after we left.
Considerable.
Thank you.
Anything for you, girl.
Good morning. My question isn't about Power Rangers. My question is about a movie you guys are in called The Order. Do we get any new news on that? Because I keep track of it, and I'm excited about it.
10,000 years ago in a land far away. No, sorry, wrong one.
Yeah, we're getting ready to start filming. We have our first day of filming February 1st, and we're super excited. We're going to start rehearsing. I'm sorry if you see me on my phone, but they're like texting me about some crash mats that we need for the rehearsal. And I'm like, just get them. We're gearing up, and it's super exciting. We're locking down all the locations. We're getting all the people who bought perks to be in the movie. We're scheduling all of that, and people have got lined, or they're going to participate in some of the action scenes with us, and it's really fun, really, really fun, and we're super excited to bring all new characters, a whole new modern, you know, movie to you guys, and actually get to work together. I've never got to work with these guys, so it's us and about 15 Power Rangers in total, but we have new cast from other genres and other shows coming on as well, so it should be pretty amazing.
I'm really excited for my one scene. I'm an extra in the far back right corner. I get to stand there picking my nose with a really long wig on. I'm pretty excited for that. I hope you guys can see me.
Guy number two.
Thank you. The only other thing I have to say is, David, I'm actually from Council Bluffs, Iowa.
Are you really?
Yes. And I moved out here, and it's pretty exciting to see somebody that's from where I'm from, too.
Awesome. I'm actually going to do a Comic-Con in Omaha, Council Bluffs, this year, so I'm really excited to
go back. My brothers will all be at that, so.
Awesome. Cool. So thank you. Well, welcome to Sacramento.
Hello.
Hello.
This question's actually for you, Austin. Okay. What did it feel like to turn evil and fight Jason David Frank?
Amazing. It was such a short-lived fight, too. But it was a good time. How many movies have you guys seen where there's a bad guy? Right? It's about every movie in time except for The Love Note, I don't know. The bad guys always have the fun. So I felt bad because I think it was a Yellow Ranger I got to smack around too. That was Nakia, I think. So I beat up 3 Rangers in 5 seconds and then dove into a fire pit. So it was exciting, but you know, didn't last that long. It was a good time. I love being a bad guy. If you got any great scripts for bad guys, let me know. So I thought when you came up with a Pokemon shirt on, I think we were in London. That's what I said. Anyway, petite, petat, potato, tomato, whatever.
It's important.
So then you'll enjoy this question. I had, she must have been a 7 or 8 year old girl that came up, and she was Pokemon'd out. And she looked at me and she said, "So if Power Rangers and Pokemon were gonna fight, who would win?" So let's get an opinion. Let's get a show of hands. All right? And I won't be offended much. Who's gonna pull for Pokemon?
Millions of Pokemon.
Yeah. Oh, wow. Traitors. All of throw them out. Security and Power Rangers. Okay, I think Power Rangers has it in this room at least. When they, all the Power Rangers fans, when they get outside, they'll be like, "Really, we were pulling for Pokemon." So, I'm going to put that up on Facebook. I want to see how many votes we get both ways and see what happens.
And Instagram.
Yes.
And I'll put it up on Instagram.
So what would it be like, Poke Rangers or Power Mon, if there was ever a clash?
These are real. So I wrote this down, but I understand that you guys have writers, but did you have any input on what happened to your characters in the story?
You could suggest stuff. When we came on, we kind of just followed the rules because they were a well-oiled machine and they were developing characters, and all I would ever do is walk by the office and go, "Write Aisha episodes, write Aisha." Because when you have a cast of 6 people, it's obviously every episode can't be about your character, but I loved it when we did get an opportunity to have a storyline. But I don't know, how was it for you?
For me, it was I think I got lucky out of most people because I got to play a character that was different than who I was as a person. So I really got to develop Billy, and then since I was on the show the longest, over the time that I was on the show, you really got to see Billy transform into super nerdy guy to, an okay guy. But I did get to have quite a bit of influence on that. Billy losing glasses and getting contacts and all that kind of stuff. So, and getting out of overalls. That was the big thing for Billy to do.
He fought for that.
I fought hard for that.
Every time they could, they had overalls hanging in the room. I remember coming on, and that was kind of the thing. He was like,
big debate.
Let's lose overalls, let's lose the glasses.
Yeah.
Like, he's been on 100 episodes.
I watch
he's gotten cooler hanging out with these guys.
Yeah. So, I mean, but overall, the writers and producers have control of that, but I personally got to have some say in my character, so.
I just recall if there was something in the script that I felt like my character wouldn't do, I could go, Zach wouldn't do that. He wouldn't set in the background, he would step up because of this reason or whatever, that kind of thing, or obviously with hip hop keto, I had to dance and do martial arts at the same time. So I had to kind of figure out how that would work in different situations, so I was responsible for that. But otherwise, I think the writers would come up to us and go, we're writing a script for you next week. And you're like, really? What is it about? Yeah, you'll see. Okay. I'm walking on stilts. That's interesting.
Thank you.
Thank you. Good question.
Hey, guys. So my question is, what is your guys' opinion or take on the new movie that's being released this year, since it's basically a reboot? So what do you guys see it as? Is it something kind of cool, or is it kind of silly? Because, I mean, for me personally, I kind of feel it a little silly. I'll give it the benefit of the doubt, because my heart and soul lies with the original guys, you know, and the original episodes and everything like that. So what's your guys' take on it?
Your heart and soul lies with the originals? Did you raise your hands for Pokemon or Power Rangers?
You know what I wrote on my
Just checking. Anybody got a photo with that?
All right. I mean, we get questions about the movie all the time. And I know Dave has had some conversations with some of the actors. I had a very brief Twitter conversation with my counterpart. I can tell you that they're taking it very seriously. I mean, they understand, 40 countries, 90 languages around the world. There's going to be one or two people watching it. And more than one or two are going to have memories of the original cast, and they're going to be bringing their children. So they know they've got some big shoes to fill, and I think they're in a hell of a position, because let's go back and recreate the very first Star Trek or the very first Star Wars. I mean, these are megalithic shows that people have burned into their memories that are important for so many different reasons with different folks. So to go back and do that, let me tell you right now, you're not going to make 100% of the people happy. So you're going to get shot at, and you're going to have other people that are going to love it. So they're kind of darned if they do, darned if they don't. I'm just waiting really to... I can't wait to see the end product. I just want to go out and see it. And I have tried to stay away from all the conjecture and the questions and the costumes, because I don't want any of that in my mind. I just want to go in, and I want to sit down and watch the film. You know what I mean? The one photo, I've seen a few photos because I can't help it. And I can tell you that Rita is hot. Other than that, I'm trying to stay away from it. If you got any pictures of Rita, you can post them on my Facebook.
Thanks, guys.
What's the name of the chick playing Rita?
Lisa Banks.
That's why she's hot.
Hi, guys. I just had one question for you guys all. After the show, did you guys get to keep any of your props? Or any props disappear after the show?
That you guys might know.
Do you work for the police?
Do you work for Hans Bond?
I didn't take any of them. And I probably should have, but I didn't.
I didn't take anything. I should have. I was a very honest person, and they didn't inform me on the let's steal something from the set day. So if I'd have been informed, I'd have been all down.
I have the skateboard from the original pilot, which is kind of cool. I didn't steal it. It was just, we have it. All right, thank you. That's cool. One of the very few things they gave us. I never got the suit or the coins or Morphers or anything like that. Also obtained later the juice bar sign. the Ernest Juice Bar sound, so I have that. That was after the show was kind of over and they were getting rid of it. My friend ended up with it. He was one of the stunt guys. He was like, hey, do you want this? It's in my garage. I was like, yeah. So there's that. And I think one time after filming late, I went home with the shirt I was wearing for the set, and it's still hanging in my closet. So.
Thank you guys so much.
Yeah. No, I was going to be the only one that's going to get in trouble because I literally stole stuff. These guys are good. But no, I blame my stealing on Jason David Frank because he encouraged me to do so. Most of my stealing, all of it for the most part, was from the movie. So when Zordon's glass thing crashes and he's laying in his bed, I stole some of the crystals from his bed. But foolishly, when I first started doing Comic-Cons, I like to give away gifts, and I gave those away to people just free. So people don't even know what they have in their hands. I did steal my ninjetti outfit from the movie. So I have that hanging in my closet. So, guilty.
Thank you. Hello.
Hi.
So we've seen a lot of role reprisals over the years, especially like Jason David Frank playing Tommy over and over and over and over. I was wondering if you guys were offered the chance to do the same thing, come in a mentor role like he's done, or reprise your role and still morph again, would you guys do it? And you know, yes or no, why?
They asked me back a couple times. It just, again, like when I left the show, I literally joined SAG, I joined the union, so I could never do it. It just never worked out, and they're very ungenerous. So it was always something really crazy, so it just never worked out. But yeah, I would love to if it were the right situation. I think all of us would love to go back, and I know you guys want that, so we would love to do it if it were the right situation.
That's about it. I mean, the four of us have standards, so we, you know, don't just keep coming back over and over and over and over and over and over again. I think what she says is true. If the situation were right and it was well done and we weren't just hooking ourselves out, we would.
Thank you.
Hello. So, my question is, I know Power Rangers is a kid's show, so when I watched it, I was also a kid. So a lot of the story, the morals are very black and white. It's very clear what's going on. I only watched the first three seasons, and then kind of everything else just kind of moved past it.
Mighty
Morphin
or nothing, right?
Yeah.
Yeah. Yes!
So I was wondering if the show, you, in your opinion, have ever move to, you know, areas where the right and wrong wasn't so clear, or is there any kind of more complex, you know, plot lines than, you know, let's beat the bad guys?
For the time that I worked on the show, the first 85 episodes or whatever, it was pretty black and white like that. It's like, we're good guys or bad guys. Occasionally there was a plot twist where something made us into a bad guy, and then we had to find our way back, that kind of thing. But I know that there was that film, that the dark film that came out on the internet a couple years ago. That was an interesting take on where the Power Rangers could go, and like, where would they be now, you know, with PTSD kind of thing. But, I think as adults now, you guys are adults now, I think something like that would be probably interesting to people. But it would have to be different from Power Rangers, because Power Rangers is definitely something that draws goodness to kids and gives that lesson. And I'm proud of that. That's what we did, because you guys are here today. We hear stories all the time about people going, I became an officer because I wanted to be like a Power Ranger. I did this in my life where I got kids in this way because I wanted to be like you guys. So I think the goodness matters, and I'm happy that that's part of what we did.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Hello.
Okay. First of all, I just want to say that you guys should go onto YouTube, look up Key & Peele Power Falcons. You will not be disappointed. And my question is, best memories of Bulk and Skull, or Jason Harvey and Paul Schreier.
Oh, yeah.
I always love hearing stories about those about those two nutcases.
We still have memories. I mean, we still
there's
hang
so
out
many.
With them.
Here's one for you.
I saw them last week.
And they made a dark day turn into a bright day for me.
Yeah. I'll say this. They're such talented actors. Like, they're amazingly talented. And they obviously have, they're known for their comedy. But that was one of the main reasons, like I saw them last week, one of the main reasons when we decided to do the order, I was like, they have to be in this because I want them to be known as actors and like have an opportunity to step out of the comedy. But they constantly, I mean, even to this day, when we know we're doing a Comic-Con with them, we know it's going to be some craziness. We know we're all going to have dinner. We know they're going to make us laugh and they're going to take over, you know, the panel. We're just going to be laughing and it's going to be a good time. I mean, they're just good guys. Good. I mean, but yeah, they would play practical jokes. They would constantly be punching each other. It never ends. They're really like that in real life. They're really good guys.
Cool. You guys, I see various ages here. I see a few people with some gray in their hair. So you guys remember Laurel and Hardy and Abbott and Costello and stuff like that? Okay. All right. Some of you seen the reruns. The reason I mention those is because Narvi and Schreier were the Abbott and Costello and Laurel and Hardy, and what were the two dorks on Mork and Mindy of the 90s? And they just there's guys that are funny, there's guys that have comedy ability, but if you take two of those super funny guys, put them into a room and ask them to make something hilarious, a lot of times they can't, because one thing they might not have is called timing. And Paul Schreier and Jason Narvi, they're comedic sense of humor and their timing together and understanding of one another, it's hard to find in the business. They're incredible. They're incredible. On and off set. It never stops.
Yeah.
And we love it. I can remember when we were shooting the movie Turbo, I was there to be evil. And I came out, of course, I was the last one to know what they were doing. They'd been going around behind the scenes. How many of you have seen the interviews that are out there where they stole my chair? Okay. For some reason, I got a chair, and they stenciled my name on it when I came back, which was funny. I'm sure it was meant as a joke, but it was funny anyway. So these two stole my chair, and they went around and started interviewing the other cast members and the directors, talking about, so why is it us and St. John got a chair and you didn't? You know, and, I mean, just like inflammatory but funny, and I mean, all the way, all the cast members and everybody has their take on it. They got to Jason Frank, and he was just like, I don't want to talk about it. I don't want to talk about it. You know, so everybody had their comic thing. And then at the very end, I come back around, and I've got my red eye contacts in, and I look at them, and I'm just like, I'm still evil. And I'm like, find my chair. And they go running off around the corner, you know, and that's the end of the videotape. So, I mean, that was their...
Okay. That... I had almost forgotten about that, but... That was just great. Thank you very much.
You okay?
I'm fine. Okay. And please get them to come to Sacramento. That will be a dream come true. And I hope I can be an extra in the order movie. Thank you.
I got money.
Hey, guys. So, you know, Walter mentioned that he has, you know, a couple of props from the show. And yeah, David, you have the suit. Is there anything from the show, or like whether it's collectibles, artwork that you guys gotten over the years, is there a particular favorite one that you have in your collection?
I don't have any.
Oh.
You mean just like of all the merchandise?
Yeah, merchandising or anything from the show or whatnot.
Yeah, I mean, a very sweet girl made me my helmet, and I mean, it's honestly become the most favorite thing that I own because I've been able to take it all around the world. And everyone has a picture holding it, and it's just like something that has become larger than life. It's beat up, it's thrashed, it's, you know, we're constantly like gluing it back together. But it's just that thing that everyone loves when they come to the table, they're like, oh, I get to hold it, you know, and so it's kind of a moment for the fans, and I love that. But yeah, we get the best gifts. Like, you guys have given us so many great things. Like yesterday, I didn't know, I mean, I knew that my pop, well, there was a gold, like limited, one. Like a limited edition gold one, and a guy, you know, we did a little barter, and he gave it to me. So, I mean, I love collecting stuff.
I think probably one of my favorite things that I have from the show now that I didn't ever before, really. Well, maybe a few, but not like today because everybody's got a camera on their phone. I'll sit down with my boys and my daughter, and I'll go through Facebook photos, and I save a lot of the photos that you guys post to my page. And I didn't this year, in fact, I need to put up a collage of this is where we were, you know, together in 2016. I love to go through and sit down and see the little ones and you guys and your parents and look at the different photos because it's these little captured moments of time where I see various stages of joy, pictures of people just full on tears and snot. And I get to sit back, and that's a very, at least, it's almost a tangible thing for me because I look at them and I remember those emotions and I remember those people. And it fills me with joy to look at that and see a small portion of the people around the world that we've all had such an incredible effect on. So I think for me today, that's probably one of the most special things I have. Thank you, guys.
Hello again. So I just finished my studies at Chico State like last year, and I did a liberal studies degree, which means I had a lot of time on my hands. So in that time, I watched like every season of Power Rangers I was at the time, which was like 17 or 18 or something. I don't know. It was a lot of fun. But I was just curious for you guys. I love Mighty Morphin. It's one of my favorites, but I have my other favorites. Do you guys have another favorite that if you had been offered, you might have joined in on that? I mean, not necessarily reprising your role, like I said earlier, but I mean, if you had been offered a different series, is there one that you guys would pick?
What is wrong with you?
Don't get me started.
I'm just kidding. Well, first of all, is Chico still the number one party school in America?
Yeah.
Is it really?
Not according to the list, but according to the Chico States. Yeah. This Chico State grads.
Yeah, my sister went to Chico, and that was
big
back then.
Did she graduate?
She's very successful, actually.
Okay.
So.
Okay.
She's me too. What a surprise.
Are you? That's good.
No, I'm not. I work for the YMCA now. It's not.
Well, you're helping kids out, so that's good then.
You got a degree in Miller Lite?
Hate you, actually.
Okay. For me, I haven't really watched any of the other series, and I didn't watch the show when I was on it, and I think a lot of us are sort of the same way because we filmed it. We kind of knew what was going on. And I'm a little too old for the demographic to watch Power Rangers.
Me too.
But it's okay. But, I mean, we've all gotten to meet a lot of the actors from all the other series, and they're amazing people. And Karan was saying it the other day, like, we really need to sit down and sort of, like, really, because we're really good friends with these people now. Yeah. And it's like, oh, we should really watch, you know, what they've done. So I really want to watch. I want to watch Time Force for sure, like one or two episodes.
Me too.
And, I would love to work with them.
Yeah, they seem like a good group. What was Serena Vincent on? Jungle? No.
Lost Galaxy.
Yeah. I want to watch that one. Yeah. And
Southworth did Time Force, right?
Yeah.
Yeah, I'd like to.
So for me, Time Force and Lost Galaxy.
Who is the only female Red Ranger? What season was that?
Super Samurai. Or
yeah.
I guess PD.
Okay, so I can't do that because I can't ever take my job. I could come in as gold for that one, then I wouldn't mind.
Yeah. I mean, honestly, there isn't a Power Ranger that we've met that we don't love. Like, literally love. Like, we see each other and we're like, okay, what are we doing later? So I honestly would love to watch, you know, like, if they could collectively say, what's your favorite episode? And we could watch from each season, that would be kind of cool, just so we can see them do it.
Yeah.
I would love to see Azeem be a Power Ranger, because he's Azeem's so funny,
awesome.
And he's, like, childlike. You know, I would love to see, you know, Jason Font and Aaron, you know, Cahill and all that.
I saw some of Samurai, a little bit of Samurai, because my kids were young and they were watching, it came on every now and then. And I was like, okay, that's cool. I thought they did some cool martial arts, but otherwise I didn't really watch a lot of the other seasons. I mean, but again, we got to know a lot of the other people. Like, I was teaching Selwyn Ward salsa. And so he was like, I met him when he first got the show, and he was like, yeah, I'm the new Red Ranger, and he was all excited about the job, and he was like, yeah, he was super hyped, and I didn't get to see his episodes, but through their eyes, I get to see it. Like, I've met different Rangers, different places, and I don't know them. And they go, I'm one of the Power Rangers. I'm like, oh, okay, what season? You know, and we talk, and they're excited about it, so I get to see the vision through their eyes, you know. But I haven't seen a lot of the episodes.
You know what I would like to see? Here's my challenge for any of you that are editors, and share this everywhere. I would love to see a best of episodes from every season. I'd love to have that compilation put together so that I think I could sit down in less than 800 episodes and get a feel for what the other guys did. You know what I mean?
Just one episode though, right? From each season.
Yeah, probably. Okay.
That's like 20 episodes. That's enough.
Right.
And I'm sorry, I took your question in a different direction than what you wanted, so I apologize.
What is wrong with you?
I don't know. I'm a year older, and it's affecting me.
Thank you very much.
Thank you. We have two more questions, right? Okay, and then after that, we'll end, but I have one thing to give away at the very end, so don't run away.
Huge fan. I don't have a question, but you remember, when going back to the Chico State thing, I have twin brothers and a sister, two sister-in-laws who graduated from Chico State.
Really? I imagine a lot of people in this area go to Chico.
That was what I wanted to say.
Oh, well, that's great. And nice Pokemon shirt.
Yeah, thank you. Thank you.
All right, Mom, I get it.
Pokemon. Don't you know? Yeah.
That's right, correct us.
So you guys, I've been lucky enough to see one of the actual screen use helmets, and they're so small. I was wondering, when you guys got the outfits, were they custom made for you guys? Because I know you guys are pretty big, and these things are about the size of heads and bigger bodies than the actual suits on the from the Japanese version. And then you guys had like a neck brace when you would wear it. Would you guys get a special different suit, or were they just the same suits brought over?
Well, I remember when we got the first suits were kind of a joke, I thought. They didn't fit right, they were baggy. And you see a few pictures out there of me in like this Red Ranger suit where there's wrinkles everywhere. That was from the original pilot, and very quickly after that, they were airtight everywhere else. But it was spandex, so the suit wasn't miserable, except when you had to pee. Because it was, the ladies who were used to the bras, they were like, I got this. The guys who were like, hey, can you help me out? I'm about to be the Yellow Ranger. So, anyway, but I remember the helmets were, it was bad. It was definitely it must have been like stunt helmets from Japan. Because I can remember turning and like whipping my head around to do a fight, and the helmet would just keep going. So now I was like staring at my ear. So the original helmets left a little bit to be desired.
Yeah, I mean, we were basically the same size as the cast. We weren't that much bigger. Sorry to disappoint.
They were altered though. The suits were altered. I mean, I remember Shani. Was her name Shani?
Shana.
She would.
He's got a thing for names. Then.
She would like take safety pins and like safety pin and make everything tight, and then she come back the next day and it was fit.
Yeah, I mean, for the original pilot, we didn't really. They kind of threw them together, and then we went to series. Yeah. They custom made them for us, so it's like they fit appropriate.
Now I always saw them clean. Were they washed during the TV or?
They left them dirty. Of course they were
washed. I see you guys well on the dirt, and then the next shot you guys would be clean.
No, they washed them, and we each had like three of our own suits. So we had three, and then the stunt people had three. So it's like there was a lot of suits to be worn.
We were lucky because they washed ours, but if you had to wear a monster suit.
Oh man.
Because those are not just washable. You can't put it in a washing machine.
Like you can't wash them.
Those, and they were, they've been used
a lot
before from Japan.
Those things stank.
They stank. They had them aired out as you walked to the studio. They were like monsters all along the way, right? So you walk and you see them, different monsters hanging up, and they were hanging out to air dry. But Yeah.
Well, the whole front room had its own smell, too.
It had its, yeah. You know what it smelled like in a football locker? Yeah. Yeah, yeah. Monster Punk is something different.
But, did you guys ever wear the putty suits? Did
you
guys ever get
to be a
putty?
It's not team, but I never put one on for fun, if that's what you mean. I did put Rita's hat on once. That was cool.
Thank you very much.
And I forgot... You know, the Green Ranger's gone, but I like your t-shirt too. I just want to make sure I got that out there.
You should do a documentary on the making of Power Rangers featuring the van through Venice Beach and Smell-O-Vision.
Smell-O-Vision.
That's great. All right, well, we thank you. So thank you for coming to see us so early on a Sunday morning in the rain. And I have, this is from 1995? No, this is a 1993. So as a lot of you like to come up to my table and tell me now, I'm vintage. So, will you sign my vintage doll? So, all right. Well, this is vintage from 1993. It's amazingly got the four of us, and we've all autographed the back. So, I'm going to give this to James because you answered the question.
Don't open it, James. Don't open it.
And thank you all.
Like ever. Yeah.
Well, you'll be coming to more, James. And now, James, now you really have to listen to your mother, okay? And you're gonna train really hard to be like a Power Ranger, right?
Right. Power Ranger and James.
Yeah. You gotta listen the first time.
Actor. Yeah. All right, thank you all. Please come to our tables, take pictures with us. We'll sign autographs. We love you. Thank you.
Hey, before everybody gets up and goes.